washed up. This is really similar to another expression that we explained in a previous video, when you lose your touch. It means you used to be good at something, but now you're not so good at it anymore. When we say washed up, the first thing I think of is usually someone is getting old, and they're not as good as they used to be at something. So the first examples that always pop into my head have to do with sports. Maybe there was a basketball player, he was really good in his prime, he was like the best player in the league, but as he got older and older and older, he got more washed up. He wasn't as good as he used to be. So another example that we use washed up a lot is like actors, right? There are some actors that we love so much and they're so good when they're in their prime, but as they get older and older, maybe they lose some of their acting skills, maybe they're not as good as they used to be, then we would say, ah, those actors are kind of washed up. There are a lot of similar expressions to this. There's over the hill, means they're kind of old, they're past their prime. Another one is past their prime, right? Your prime is your best situation that you've ever been. If you're past your prime, you're not as good as you used to be. Even though all of us are gonna get older and older, it doesn't mean we all have to be washed up. As long as you guys are working really hard at your skills, including your English, you don't have to be washed up. So keep working hard, guys.
English. 여러분들, 오늘 표현은요, washed up 이라는 표현입니다. Washed up. 사실 이 washed up 같은 경우는 오리진을 보시면요, 어디서 나왔는지 간단하게만 설명드릴게요. 좀 기억에 남을 수 있습니다. 이 물고기들이요, 다 이렇게 휩쓸려 와서 가끔 가다 보면요, 이 연안 부분에서 해변가에 이렇게 죽어 있는 그러한 고기들, 물고기들을 본 적이 있을 거예요. 그쵸? 뭐, 사진으로 해도. 자, 그런 상황에서 washed up을 사용할 수 있는데요. 결국 사람도 아 물고기처럼 잘 나가던 그런 어떠한 시절이 있었지만 시간이 지나서 자기가 계속해서 열심히 그것을 하지 않고 했을 때 우리가 예전에 배웠던 lost my touch라는 표현이 생각이 날 겁니다. lost my touch라고 하면요. 예전에 어떠한 그것이 연습을 안 하다 보니까 그것이 지금은 안 되는 거잖아요. 잘 안 되는 거잖아요. 그럴 때 생각할 수 있는데 보통 액팅이나 아니면 스포츠 같은 경우 보시면요. 예전에는 잘 나갔어요. 물고기처럼 야! 잘하다가 시간이 지나면서 잊혀지는 그런 사람들 있잖아요. 그렇죠? 스킬도 많이 떨어지고 그런 사람들을 우리가 보통 washed up이라는 표현을 사용할 수 있습니다. He used to be really good, but you know, he's washed up. 이렇게 말할 수 있는 것이죠. 그렇죠? 자, 비슷한 표현은요. Over the hill 이런 표현, over the hill 이런 표현이 있는데요. Over the hill이라는 것은 over, hill이라는 게 언덕이잖아요. 그래서 정상으로 올라갔다가 이제 아래로 내려오는 것을 생각하시면 됩니다. 그래서 he's over the hill 하면요. 이제 정상까지 올라왔다가 이제 아래로 내리막길을 걷고 있다는 느낌으로 보시면 되겠고요.
Face it, you're over the hill. Face it, you're over the hill. Face it, you're over the hill.
그 다음에 past the prime 이라는 표현이 있는데요. 이 past the prime, prime이라는 게 바로 뭐냐면 최고의 정점입니다. 그럼 그것을 통과했다 결국 어때요? 정점에서 내려오는 느낌이죠. 그렇죠? So past the prime. 이 washed up이나 over the hill, past the prime 다 사실 좋은 표현은 아닙니다. 사실 좀 안 좋은 표현이긴 하지만 우리가 나이가 들면서 어찌 보면요 이와 같은 것이 자연스러울 수 있겠는데 우리는 그걸 그냥 당연하다고 생각하는데 그러지 마세요. 나이가 들어도 계속해서 발전할 수 있다고 생각을 하거든요. 그렇기 때문에 여러분들도 영어는 어때요? 나이 탓하지 말고 계속해서 꾸준히 열심히 하시는 걸 제가 추천드립니다. 아시겠죠?
Few weeks ago, I was a washed-up actor with a drinking problem. Few weeks ago, I was a washed-up actor with a drinking problem. Few weeks ago, I was a washed-up actor with a drinking problem. Few weeks ago, I was a washed-up actor with a drinking problem. Few weeks ago, I was a washed-up actor with a drinking problem.
Get yourself another hero, kid. I'm all washed up. Get yourself another hero, kid. I'm all washed up. Get yourself another hero, kid. I'm all washed up. Get yourself another hero, kid. I'm all washed up. Get yourself another hero, kid. I'm all washed up.
I think I want my money back.
I'm a failure. I'm all washed up.
I think I want my money back.
I'm a failure. I'm all washed up.
I think I want my money back.
I'm a failure. I'm all washed up.
I think I want my money back.
I'm a failure. I'm all washed up.
I think I want my money back.
I'm a failure. I'm all washed up.
자, 여러분들 오늘 표현 washed up 살펴봤고요. 우리 그럼 또 다음 시간에 또 뵙도록 하겠습니다. See you guys next time. Take care. Bye bye. Later.